cold as shit, and we're about to leave the house. That's it. If it ain't with us, it ain't going. Let's get a party going, let's get a party going, let's get a party going, party hard, party hard, party hard, party hard, party hard, wake up everybody!
It's gotta be.
For the trip?
Yeah.
We've made it to John's house and our chariot awaits us.
Today is the day that we take off in the bus and we're heading to Slab City. First, we're to pick up Joe and Maddie from the airport.
Oh my God, there it is.
What?
It's right there. I see him. Do you see him? I see him.
Oh
I see him.
No. Right.
Come on, let's cross.
No.
We gotta cross. There it is. The dream bus. There he is. There he is. Oh, we're already cross shooting.
Doug is filming Joe and Maddie get on. Here they come.
Come on in!
Ah! This one's
ready.
Oh my God.
I can't.
I'm filming you, filming
you.
You
filming? Hurry up! All right.
Everybody oh, is. Sweet home, baby!
We're done.
All right, picked up me and Maddie from the airport. We're going to pick up Giselle. We are taking on water. It's raining inside and out. We're going to the desert. Probably good.
Probably.
Jesus.
You're marrying this.
Why?
Am I? Because I can still change my mind.
He knows
what to do.
Oh my God. Look at him. Oh my God.
She's a dirty girl.
You're raping Gloria.
You are a bunch of horn dogs.
So we are now picking up the last party on our bus. It is Giselle.
Welcome aboard.
Hey.
Hi!
Happy birthday!
Happy birthday!
Thanks,
happy birthday!
Hi.
I don't think we've met.
No.
My name's Giselle. Nice to meet you.
I'm Maddie. Nice to meet you.
Wipers on the bus go swish, swish, swish. All through the town.
That's a mountain.
So we are at our first stop. We are at the Salton Sea. It smells like rotten fish and cow manure and every foul smell you can possibly think of. It looks pretty though.
Better patch of dirt somewhere,
yeah,
Joe.
This patch of dirt looks dirty compared
we
to the other.
We have a lot of bushes to pee in. There is more bushes in this area to pee in. I'm pretty sure people might be.
Give me a lantern. I'm gonna go scout.
Yeah.
Right? Our fearless leader,
what?
Who led us into the dirt. What just happened there?
So it seems we set up on a road.
No. Middle of. Where'd
road.
We set up?
Middle of a road.
Middle right of
here.
A road.
This right here where the bus is.
Yeah.
Road.
So where are we going?
Where it's not a road, preferably, I think.
Oh, okay. We're going to go over there.
Across the street.
Across the street. Well, actually not across it, just halfway across because we're already in the middle
of it. We're already in the middle of the motherfucker.
Dude, is this a rug?
Yeah, look, it's private here.
Private. Why does it say private?
Private. That's because that's the dude, that's the guy that we were just talking to.
Oh, that's his stuff. Oh, okay. I get it.
No. Who's leading?
Me.
No.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Giselle. Happy birthday to you!
Yay!
This is from all of us.
Oh yeah.
It's a coat.
That looks.
Oh great. My god.
I definitely needed one though.
That looks.
This is the first step.
Now I can tell you. So I made this so that we can do. You ready?
What is that? What is that?
This is the soap.
Okay.
So, you ready?
Okay.
You ready for this?
I'm not sure.
What?
What's going on here?
We're gonna christen it. We're gonna christen Gladys.
Gladys.
Why?
It's official.
Why? This is her first trip.
It's her maiden voyage. You gotta christen a ship, right? I hope that we have safe seas, and it's not too cold. She doesn't break down, and she doesn't catch on fire. I feel like that's a big thing.
Yeah, pouring beer on it will help.
She is officially christened.
You're up next.
I hope she makes it. I really hope she makes it.
That was profound.
Well, Gladys, I've seen you grow. But like, I saw your personality, and hopefully you get us through this trip. There you go.
I mean, I just need this to last until Tuesday.
Dear Gladys, please also make it to our wedding, because I would like to ride you to our marriage. And here's to a big bottom woman. Because she's a big bottom woman.
Gladys, you're the oldest woman I will ever be inside. But I'm going to ride you till you die. Which hopefully won't be soon.
There's our humble abode for this evening.
Window?
Whatever.
I mean, that's a shitty side anyways. It might still be wet.
Y'all.
G'day! Hi. My butt's in a crack.
Are you filming?
I'm blind. Good night.
Oh, God.
We're in the middle of the desert, and it's raining.
It's raining.
It's fucking raining.
And the
it's
bus
raining. It happens like 3 times a year.
We won the...
Aren't we fucking lucky?
We won the unfortunate pull where we had to sleep in the tent, but guess what? The tent don't leak.
That's true.
That tent, bus is leaking.
Tent probably leaks less than the fucking bus. Fucking desert, and it rained on us.
I know,
because
we jinxed it.
Fuck us, dude.
What are we about to do here, Doug?
We're gonna go visit Raven, who was the nice fellow that told us we were trying to camp in the middle of a road last night. He's like, hey, don't camp on that road. Camp by my place. It's nice and safe, and you don't have to worry about nothing, because I'm right there.
Guys, it's warm.
He's come over and talked to us. Seems like a nice guy, and offered to give us a tour of his house, so we're gonna go get a tour of his house and give him some brews for thanks. He built it all himself over the last 8 months. It's all off the grid, built by himself.
This is what is called a three-step kitchen.
Oh.
From the website, and that means that within 3 steps is everything I need to do my cooking. Out here we use ice for cooling, so I've got 2 very good coolers over here.
Oh, yeah.
And my perishable food goes in them. At my bedroom over here, which has a hard ceiling so that the rain doesn't bother.
That's cool.
Well, as you can see, everything else is cloth.
For the rain that happens 3 times a year.
It's like a yurt. This is awesome.
So that I can raise and lower my walls. That way it controls the shade and the wind flow. There's a guy, Ernie, who comes in once a month. He runs an orphanage and a soup kitchen. And he comes in with his big truck and another guy with a trailer.
With all the
and they
good
bring
stuff.
In all kinds of furniture and whatnot, and they raffle it off. And I have my radio, and there's a super, I got from Solar Mike, a high output solar panel on my roof here. that goes through that inverter
okay.
and charges that deep cycle battery.
Nice.
Oh, that's what we got.
I was gonna say we got something similar on the bus.
Yeah,
that gives me all the power I need for lights at night and stereo and running my laptop, watching movies.
Today?
This is Slab Radio. This is two sites over is Art, and he runs Slab Radio at 107 FM. Right.
Being so accommodating.
Oh, that's awesome. That's good. I'll have that with lunch.
We'll be in touch with you.
Aaron, have a good one.
Guys.
See ya.
Turned it down. I was like,
"Fuck,
something is wrong."
See anything wrong?
No smoke, no nothing. Make funny noises though.
Well, you did get her drunk last night.
It smelled like it was.
Yeah, I don't smell anything. Wait, now I smell something. Yeah, I smell something.
Yeah. Yeah. That's an oil leak.
What's wrong? Do you know?
She's leaking oil.
Well, you want to look up, see if there's any gas stations close? We might be able to get some oil. Like, we'll just limp there.
It's coming from the drive shaft.
Like, you can see the end of the thing?
Like, the thing that turns when you drive is leaking oil.
Oh, okay. It's not coming from above there, though?
I'm pretty sure it's coming from there.
Do you have any extra oil?
That's why I would say get to the gas station and get extra oil to find me too.
Yeah.
The closest one is 17 miles.
Yeah. You're in buttfuck nowhere.
Yeah.
What was that?
I don't know.
Are you trying to help her?
Someday this will all be funny.
78.
It's leaking oil, so we're gonna add oil. Eventually, it'll just seal itself.
Right?
Yeah, I think that's the way oil works. Doug, why do we keep doing these trips with stupid cars when we know nothing about cars? It's
hey,
like,
why don't we have any mechanic friends? Like, what the fuck are we thinking?
Right now,
it's perfect level. I mean,
perfectly low.
No, it's level. Right in the middle.
So we're not. We didn't lose too much, which is probably why it's still running.
So why are you at season? I thought you said it was good. It was hot, so maybe... That's right. A brand new... What else do I do? I mean, go look under there and see if... I mean, what do we know, though? It's just like... Yep,
we know if we see a hose and there's there's shit coming out of it. There shouldn't be. And we know that. But we don't know where the hoses are or what to do.
There's fucking oil everywhere.
But this is dry, okay?
Uh-huh.
That's not dry.
Uh-huh.
So we're moving this way, right?
Uh-huh.
Oil all here, all there.
Uh-huh.
Okay?
Yeah.
So it seems like most wet here.
I don't think he's coming back out.
We're gonna
what are we going
to
do?
We're going to take it to a mechanic. If he tells me it's like catastrophic, then we're going to find some cars to rent, and we're going to continue the trip, and we're going to bury Gladys somewhere.
Well, this is the drive shaft, we think. And that's not there anymore. That doesn't look like an easy fix.
What?
That looks like we're in trouble.
I'm looking for a tow. It's a small RV. It's an E350 shuttle bus. I'm debating whether I just want to fucking limp. This is going to be so expensive.
We made it this far. We know what it is.
Okay. All right. So you don't have a flatbed type of deal.
Are you surprised?
Yep.
Let's limp. Limpy.
That's her new nickname.
Gimpy Gladys. Gladys the Gimp.
So worst case scenario is Gladys just died. And she's dead and we never revive her.
What's the best case scenario?
Best case scenario is we lose a day. And it's fixed by the end of the day or by tomorrow. And we just lose a day. It's not that big of a deal.
What if Gladys is dead?
And she's dead. And we leave her to die. We bury her in the desert.
We christened her last night and then we bury her today.
He goes under the thing, he looks and goes, oh shit. Which I believe is about what we said.
Yeah, that is what we said.
We have to go to another place because we need someone who works on transmissions. So this is part two of our saga of trying to fix the bus.
Why would I do dumb shit?
Because it's hilarious.
This wasn't
dumb. We wouldn't be friends.
We could have just rented a van. All could have gotten a van, rental, wouldn't have worried about anything. Would have went to our destinations, had a blast, came home, gave the van back. That's it. Now,
but this is better.
I'm driving cancer around.
We lay out a basic plan, and then we go where the universe pulls us.
Which was exactly.
To Yuma.
Did you hear about the two satellites that got married? The wedding wasn't much, but the reception was fantastic.
Alright, guys. I'll be back.
Good luck.
Transmission's completely fucked. They will need probably at least a week to fix it, get all the parts. So grab what you can, and we're walking the rest of the way.
Walking trip.
Backpack, I have a backpack.
Can we run camels?
Llamas?
They have donkeys, maybe. We have to cross them over from Mexico, though.
No, it's not that bad. They think probably about 3 or 4 hours.
Are you fucking kidding me? Yeah. You fucking dick! Oh my god!
Do we still get to ride burros?
Yeah, what do you want on your sandwich?
Yeah, they have the part that they need. Randomly.
Oh my god!
I am so happy for you.
They're gonna put it up, and as long as it's the right part and everything, they're gonna change it. Should be done in.
Is it reasonable in terms of cost?
Yeah, it's not bad.
Okay,
it's not bad at all. Keep driving and it wiggles around and breaks that part again, even if they replace that part. So we have to get a new drive shaft or repair the old drive shaft. She's calling around to see price-wise what we're talking about and time-wise what we're talking about. Best case scenario, it's done tomorrow afternoon probably. Worst case scenario, it's done Wednesday or Thursday. So I think we should rent a car. Take whatever we need for 2 days.
No
go out to White Sands, do the wedding, have fun, come back Wednesday or Thursday, get the van, get the bus, drive up to Vegas.
Flip it up, flip it up. Got an update?
She just called. The bus is going to go take a visit to Mexico to hopefully fix the drive shaft. And then we'll get to go, baby.
Wait, is this today?
They're going to take it over tomorrow, I think.
Oh, okay.
Just leave it, just dump it in the seat. It's just closed.
What are your parting words?
Let's hope this one doesn't break down.
Guys, we have to hurry. John just said that the transmission place is closing, and he's gonna be here in 2 minutes to pick us up. Thank you. We're going. John's holding us up.
Chug.
Yeah, finish this beer.
We were waiting on the bus. Now we're waiting on the van.
We're waiting on the van. Waiting on the van.
Uh-oh. Oh, there he is.
The big fuzz is here.
Coming around the Christmas tree. Coming around the mountain, she gooms. Honk it, baby, honk it! Or not. Load up! Oh.
Hurry up, they're trying to close the
camera. I'm going!
Oh. Fuzz, what'd you say?
It's 5:04.
They close at 5.
Where's the clock in this thing?
It's 5:04.
Oh, they're holding the door for us.
No.
Yep. Oh, shit, what a bunch of dicks.
He didn't call them.
What?
They're not holding the door for us.
It's not like we haven't broken somewhere before, right?
We have an expert breaker-innerer.
It's not great. That's why they have barbed wire fence.
All right, get your shit. We got 2 minutes.
Damn it. All right.
Get everything?
Grab all the shit you're gonna need for the next 2 days for your wedding and to film everything. So don't, no pressure, but you got 2 fucking minutes. Do it, motherfucker.
This is our new car. This is the best. Died. Hopefully we'll see her again in 2 days.
Gladys, you fucking bitch.
Alright! Here we go!
And we're
not
off.
Quite as epic as we were looking for.
Oh boy.
We had an aisle, gone. Had leg room, gone. Had
a cooler with all our food that's now gone. Thanksgiving's gone.
Oh.
That food's gonna get ruined.
Having a conversation.
Dude, is there one fucking road open in this whole city?
I don't know.
Like one lane road?
Poor Fuzz.
He did all this to get us moving and to get us going. We're just stuck in you.
Guys, guide. Couples turkey trip. Trapped in Yuma.
There you go.
So close, we're like an hour away from White Sands. We're gonna get a little sleep here, wake up nice and early, go get some a marriage license, Joe and Maddie, and then we're gonna go out in the sand and marry them, I guess.
Just big, just dig hold a on, big old on, hole. On, oh! Oh! See oh!
That? See that there?
And focus there. What is that?
What signifies me a member of the clergy.
Actually, we haven't gone over that. What does that mean?
That means I'm the officiant of the wedding.
You can marry people?
I am officially.
How'd you do that?
I did it on my lunch break at work about a month ago.
What's up, buddy?
Writing the ceremony. Finishing up writing the ceremony.
Just started writing the whole thing right now?
No.
It's gonna be a smoother day than yesterday.
Yeah.
Just need to see you in your arms. You
There's nothing good here, babe.
You get ready, girl?
Do you want to? When do you want to start our lip syncing?
Today. We'll do it in the car.
You're upstaging.
You
want to
do it now?
You're upstaging my moment.
Okay. Yeah. Yeah.
I had a moment here, but ready?
Shit! I gotta listen to him now.
Someone had a wrinkly shirt.
Who would that be?
That would be you.
Some fucking dumbass.
He can't give wedding ceremony with a very wrinkly shirt.
No, the whole reason why we did this is because I wanted beautiful pictures for our wedding. Because other than that, I don't really care.
She's really there with the passion.
That's it.
The passion is there.
Well, I wanted Fez to be there.
Fine.
Because as much.
I'm excited. I wrote my vows last night in the car.
Okay.
So they're on my phone.
Nice.
So I'm worried about looking like a doofus, like reading them off my phone, but I'm not gonna be able. I'm gonna be like nervous, so I'm not gonna be able to memorize it, because I'll skip like half of it, because that's what I do. When you get nervous, you're like, fucking go to the end.
I'm nervous. I'm excited. You know, can't wait to see how I do. Nothing about you guys.
Nothing.
I'm
nothing
really
about it.
About myself.
Yeah. No, that's good. What's wrong with that? Pinkie pie.
What the hell is
Pinkie
that?
Pie is
what are you doing?
Face.
That's the beard oil.
Come on.
Stays looking so fresh and so clean.
Jeez,
I thought it was magic.
You know, this trip, I don't think we could get any worse luck. I think we actually need it along to bless things.
All right, then it's coming with us.
Wedding day number one. Joe is getting married today. I am the officiant. Got a jam-packed ceremony ready for him. I got ghost stories. We got Bible verses. We got Native American traditions. We're bringing a medicine man in, especially for this. So it's going to be a very exciting day. Joe's excited. Maddie's yelling at him a lot. A lot of tension here. Cut it with a knife.
I'm not your
father.
Are we
good? Father.
I think we're ready.
Thank you. Thank you.
So here it is.
Fold them neatly. Hopefully.
That's the wedding right there.
Hey, I'm sitting over there.
What are you doing today, Joe?
I believe I'm getting married today. Middle of the desert. We were just in the middle of the desert. It rained on us. Hopefully today goes a little better than that.
Alright, hurry up. Get in the van. Let's
get
married.
Get in the van. It's your own damn wedding. Let's go.
We got the father pissed at us already.
Stopped at Walgreens to get the potion for Joe's face for the wedding ceremony.
What about one of these?
Yeah, those look gross.
Chilada?
The jalapeno one! Kind of that's gross. The jalapeno one!
I can't do that to Joe.
Well, if you're getting tequila, I feel like, you know, we gotta go with the Tecate and tequila.
Yeah, that sounds good.
I agree with that.
Tecate and tequila.
Tecate.
Tecate.
Hurricane. New Mexico gives no fucks.
If you ever need to get married, just go to New Mexico.
Just go to New Mexico. That was like, the form was like this fucking long.
Hey,
fucking PA, that bitch was like this fucking long, dude. $50, I had to leave my cell phone in the car. Here, I could have rode in on a fucking horse and said, that's good enough.
Welcome to White Sands National Monument. It's one of the greatest wonders of the Southwest.
There's much to do and see here, from photography to countless beautiful views to sledding down the shimmering white dunes. There's also ranger guided activities which include tent talks, patio talks, and sunset strolls. To learn more about the history of White Sands, stop by the visitor center and the gift shop to pick up park memorabilia, sleds, snacks, as well as information on special events, including Joe and Natty's wedding today.
Hey, Joe, what kind of snacks they got at the gift shop?
Sand. Sandwiches.
We have one surplus person. We have me, Maddie, two witnesses, which would be you and Mindy, and we have Fuzz performing the ceremony, and then we have Giselle. She's extra. She's the PA.
Congratulations.
He's anything needs awesome. Done.
We're up to two dogs.
He is.
Secret recipe.
I'm on eye patrol.
Towards me. I don't want to spill it everywhere.
Okay.
That's probably enough. A few more.
More?
Yeah, more of that.
Second ingredient.
To be blessed by a father.
Yeah,
that's why he's blessing it right now.
Lime juice.
Yeah. Doug's mixing it because he's the healer.
Oh. Blessed Father. This is the holy nectar in which they will be wed with.
White Sands, New Mexico. Walking through a national park again with Mr. John Bear and Maddie.
Come on, Joe, you're late.
The groom has arrived.
I made it.
We're gathered here today to celebrate the marriage between Joseph Cody Nugent and Madeline Elise Yapremian. Say that right?
Close enough.
All right. As you can see, Joe invited all of his friends.
Clever.
All right, here we go.
Clever.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against you. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Continuing the ceremony, staying a little religious for you, Maddie.
Thank you.
I've prepared some readings from some of the lesser-known books of the Bible.
Okay, good.
I'm sure you know that they're, you know, our main books of the Bible, but there were other apostles that wrote some books. So to start out, I have the first reading is from Walter, chapter 3, verse 16. Love is a combination of three neurochemicals, phenethylamine, norepinephrine, and dopamine. It was created during the evolution of man. It's a reward our brains give us to keep us connected to our mate in order to protect and lengthen the lives of our offspring. We shorten that to love. The excerpt continues to describe marriage. When things go wrong, and fights happen, and disagreements take place, there's nothing you can do to avoid it. It's inevitable. But here's some words of wisdom. Get over it and move on. What did you expect? Next reading is from Leniza, chapter 16, verse 4. And I believe he really describes love and marriage in a way only he can. Love really is best described in stages. First, you have the just fucking stage, in which you both love to fuck. Next comes the idea stage, where you really both love the idea of each other. This is followed by the value stage, where you love the fact that you agreed on so much. Eventually, all this love and good tidings leads to marriage, which is taking all that love and replacing it with reality. But once you sign the long-term deal, pressure is on to perform. We have one more reading from the book of Michaels. The book of Michaels, chapter 9, verse 10. Love is an illness of the heart and soul. Love is finding your symbiotic parasite. They suck everything you have out of you, but you need each other to survive because you couldn't see your world without them.
Some days they're a blood-sucking leech, but some days they're like those little fishies that clean sharks and whales and women's feet at fancy spas. They take care of you, they clean up after you, and help you realize you're not alone in this crazy world. So you just somehow justify the blood sucking until one day you're both old and gray and you suck the life out of each other. Marriage, on the other hand, is being okay with seeing the same titties for the rest of your life. Knowing now is probably the best they'll ever look because you enjoy the company of the person they are attached to more than you used to like just boobies.
That's perfect. Joseph.
Now, I believe you've prepared your own vows. Maddie, you can start. And when you're done, you can put the ring on it.
Dear Joe, I will never be able to put into words how much I truly love you. But what I can say is that you have changed my life completely. I never thought in a thousand years that I would be standing here with you today. We have grown so much together. We've made it through a house reno, through sickness, and through the ups and downs of our careers. I love our little life we've built together, and I wouldn't trade it for the world. I will forever appreciate your support and the love that you give to me every day. I promise to be by your side whenever you need me, to take you to doctor's appointments, to help you spackle the barren walls of our house, to pick our next tiny house, to raise our kids, and to eat all the best parts of your food and drink half of your soda. Being your wife will never be a sacrifice to me. My love for you is unfathomable. It's a feeling that resonates deep within my soul. And I will always choose you to be with you in this life and the next life. You've awakened my soul in a way that I will always be grateful for. And thank you for choosing me as your good egg. For always and forever.
Good, because I don't think it's coming off.
Good.
Well, I have to say, my life is pretty awesome right now. I love my job. We finally have some money to do fun stuff. Today, I'm surrounded by my friends, as Fuzz said, all of them. I'm being married by my best friend, who moved heaven and earth yesterday just to get us here. And now, in the middle of this beautiful national park, he's going to help me marry the love of my life. Now, I know it's not going to be all rainbows and sunshine. You're always going to leave the fridge open entirely too long. And I'm going to always leave the bedside light on, whether you're sleeping or not. From the moment we got blitz drunk and passed out on the same air mattress. And then that next morning, I knew that we had something special between us. So now I say today that I want to hold that something special close to me on cold nights. I want to hold that something special, or I want to take that something special on crazy road trips across the country, no matter what goes wrong. I want to laugh at inside jokes with that something special, cow mouse. I want to build a tiny house and raise a little family with that something special. And in 50 years, when our bodies have completely changed, I will look at your same beautiful eyes and I will see that same something special looking back at me. Today I put this ring on your finger and I say that for the rest of my life, I'm never going to give up that something special.
Yes, right way. Look at you. You got to show it on there.
Borrowing from another tribe of Native Americans, the Cherokee, which I believe...
I'm putting these back on.
We're both Cherokee, correct? Making things up now?
Maybe. Cherokee.
Mindy, if you could bring over the two blue blankets, please.
Yay! My girls are looking cute. You're hiding behind the camera. I don't like that.
There you go.
Thank you.
So we put them around yourself. Put them around. We are cloaking you into individual blue blankets, which represent your past lives.
Oh, shit.
We're too short.
As master of ceremonies, you guys...
What's wrong with it?
Turn towards me, and I'll bless you individually.
That's what I wanted.
I'm sorry, I'm salty.
Okay, continuing with our Native American traditions, we have the traditional wedding vase. Bring that on up.
Oh, no.
Traditionally, the families would get together weeks before. You can face each other again. Weeks before, and the medicine man would prepare nectar for the bride and groom. I gave it to Doug.
Doug is our medicine man. That's fitting.
If you could hand it to Maddie first, please.
Thank you, Giselle.
You're very welcome.
Okay, the Native American wedding vase has two spouts, signifying both of your lives. The circle in the middle will now signify your life together. Maddie, you start off by taking your sip.
Oh, Jesus.
Now, Joe, you take your sip. Now, try and do it together. This will signify your unity and lives together.
Did you get any? I didn't get any.
I didn't get any.
We gotta drink it.
I got some.
It helps that we're the same height.
Yeah.
Now it is said, if no spills were dropped, it signifies a long and happy marriage. Yay! And hand me your blue blankets.
We'll
wrap you in one white blanket, signifying your new lives together as one.
Can we burrito ourselves?
Yeah, burrito it.
Okay. I can't, the microphone.
All right, you ready?
You burrito all the way in here and I'll catch you.
All right.
I got you.
By the power invested in me in some website that I filled out at lunch, I now pronounce you man and wife. You may kiss the bride.
Yeah!
I have to unravel her first.
You gotta pull me back.
Woo! Yay! Congratulations! Woo! Yes! I'm Mrs. D. Joe Nugent.
We gotta walk off with this
that
thing
so
together.
Good. I just I did a one.
Fine.
That's me.
Okay. Where do we go? Yay, we did it!
That's just Joe's cheap ass trying to save a buck.
Any time, the earlier the better probably for us. Okay, great. I'll, should I give you a call before we plan on getting there, or? Okay, sounds great. I'll talk to you later. Thank you.
What's up?
Gladys lives! We had to get a Mexican drivetrain, so she might have an accent now. I think it's okay, though. It's like an organ transplant.
Gladysia.
She's still herself.
I have to say Gladys. It's Gladys.
Oh, yes!
So she said we could pick it up anytime tomorrow. They're open at 8. So we should get a plan together, I guess. This is one of the ingredients in the love
ingredient potion. Number.
I'm going to call you medicine down. Man now.
A little for the father.
Yeah, we got the Tecate. We wanted to get a Colt 45 or some. Oh God, you spit.
Yeah, it's like slime.
Spitters are quitters, dude.
We got one wedding down, we got one to go. Vegas, baby.
Chug it.
Me? Oh,
yeah. Chug, 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 chug.
Oh, shit. No. Oh, no, don't throw up the
There was something yes. chunky in there. Ew. I just
Christened a new ride?
Don't you dare.
You're done. Done good with us for a day.
Stand, so far.
Stan the man van. Yeah, Stan the man van. Just get us back to our
Gladys.
Don't say that. It was bad news and we
Gladys.
Did it before. It was awful.
Say
we
you
said
hope
that, before.
That you leave us stranded.
Yeah.
You help you strand us.
Sounds like a quality establishment.
We're back in Yuma.
Your favorite place!
Back in Yuma at the El Roach Motel. We get to up again tomorrow. That's exciting. Stan the man van has been filled to capacity with shit. Too much of it.
We got her back, waiting for us right there.
We had a minor delay. However, Gladys is fixed. She's healthy, got a clean bill of health. We got a drive shaft from Mexico, tail housing from Yuma. And we're gonna get her going, see what happens here.
Are you dancing because you consummated the marriage?
Yeah, Joe did all his dancing last night.
Yeah, it's weird when you put a ring on his finger, it gets 10 times better.
I think I can officially put this on the bus, right? I'm a minister now.
Yeah, you officially.
I've done one wedding.
You've done one wedding. You've done
it. And let me say, you did a fine job, sir.
Just fine. It wasn't great.
You ready?
Yep.
Right over this one.
That's her former life. As a shuttle bus for the city of Victorville. Now, it's on Lord's work. Feel pretty good about that.
Oh
feels like home again. It feels like we went on a road trip within a road trip. Road tripception. But now we're back home, but not really. Spread out again.
Hey!
Everywhere.
Hey, look at that.
What are you talking about?
All in one sentence.
I said there's shit everywhere.
You said it's a piece of shit.
No, I said our house is a piece of shit, that there's shit everywhere.
Hey, all in one sentence, she insulted my life's work and
shit,
yours.
Holy shit, do you need a Snickers?
Yeah. I mean, he's right.
That is not what I said. I didn't say Gladys is a piece of shit. I said our house, as in there's shit everywhere.
Okay,
it's a piece of shit.
Important business. Somebody needs to drive Gladys to the rental place. Joe? Doug?
Joe. I vote Joe. Thanks.
I can.
Who wants to be the driver here?
Me.
I'm
kind
of excited. Oh. I thought it was going to be a bad
paper,
thing.
Scissors. Rock, two, scissors, shoot. Rock, paper, scissors, shoot. Rock, paper, scissors, shoot. Rock, paper, scissors, shoot.
We both have to sit together and drive.
All right, let's go again. Rock, paper, scissors, shoot.
Ah, oh, what a to the Doug man.
Rock, paper, scissors, shoot. Rock, paper, scissors, shoot. Ah,
now to the final game. Winner gets to drive, right?
Yep.
Okay.
Winner gets to?
Yep.
Rock, paper, scissors, shoot. Ah! Line champion!
Sorry, Gladys, I let you down.
You're driving.
Get to take my maiden voyage in Gladys today. Get to drive her, pick John up at the rental car, and on our way to Grand Canyon.
All right, new captain Doug.
Going in like the good old days.
Medicine man.
Everyone ready?
Oh, we got.
Doug, do you know how to drive this?
The wheels on the bus go round and round, round and round, round and round.
They did it last time we sang that song.
Oh, wait. Did we come this way last night?
I don't know.
Are we going to make that, dude?
No, he came the other way. They're looking at you.
Yeah.
Like, out the window. Look at them. There they are. They're like, are they fucking going to go through that?
They're like, they better not.
Hey, no, is something behind me? Is there any cars behind me? We didn't make clearance.
The next one.
That was a good call.
We were almost convertible. I have more respect for my high school bus driver now.
She sounds good. No vibration so far.
Yeah, sounds great.
We gotta play that song.
She likes me better.
We're all back in the bus. John's driving.
Or
dropped off the rental car. Back on the road to Grand Canyon.
this is home for the night.
That
fire biscuit.
That's cheating. Are you cheating?
No.
Yes, you are.
I collected this at REI.
So you call that gathering?
Yeah. We're at a fucking KOA. What is there gonna gather around here?
Alright, got it all set up.
Getting there.
You are ready to go.
We gotta do some dishes.
Look at you, you got like a kitchen over here. You got like almost a full kitchen.
Yeah, dude.
Where's the sink?
Right here.
This tent is still wet, FYI, so that's fun. We're gonna be cold and wet tonight.
What are you doing? Are you priming it?
No, I'm pumping it up.
What is this thing here?
This is technically a shower, but I use it as a little rinse station. Listen, we've gotten a lot of updates since first trip. We have a bus, we have women, we have a little shower thing.
We used it mainly for washing dishes and brushing teeth.
And washing our nuts.
He's washed his nuts.
Chestnuts, peanuts. The occasional cashew.
That was awesome! Oh my god.
There, see?
Hey!
Should've fucking bought a tent to REI.
What's wrong, Mindy?
It's soaked! It's fucking soaked! And it's gonna be like 19 degrees tonight.
Then it will act as an igloo. It will freeze and keep you warm.
Oh, yeah, great. That's what I want.
Igloos are very warm.
Oh, my God. No, Doug, it's soaked. The whole floor's soaked.
Yeah, no shit.
Well, I'm not sleeping in it.
How many layers do you have on?
Three. Why?
Thanks.
I'm not wearing a bra, though, so who knows in case.
Yay, boobies.
They got everything here. They got a pool and a pool table.
We have Wi-Fi.
And a basketball court, and we fucking have Wi-Fi.
Yeah, this is stupid.
I'm
this
sorry.
Is camping. This is not camping.
I don't want to be in this thing saying fuck too many times.
Fuck.
Yeah,
fuck. Fuck. Fuck.
The fire looks warm, Doug.
Look at her. Look how angry she is.
It's fuck. Wet. Fuck, we were supposed to air it out.
That's what I'm saying. That's why
we suck.
Soaked.
Well, it's 7:30 in the morning on Thanksgiving Day, and we survived the night outside in the tent. It was freezing, got down to like 19 degrees, cold as balls. Time to go wake up the other guys. Waggy, waggy. It's morning. Don't you want to get up?
What'd you say?
Look, Mom, I do dishes. In the freezing cold, too.
How's this working out?
The dishes?
Yeah.
Other than my hands being cold, pretty nifty.
Where?
Mindy, I got something else for you.
Yay! That's mine. My wine glass.
Guys are making it all wet over here.
Mindy, I got something else for you. Is that crack?
How are you doing?
I'm doing good. This is my second cup of mimosas.
Oh, you're doing really good then.
So we had an issue the other day. I thought it'd be fine. I thought the platform was high enough, but apparently the muffler, the exhaust, melted my bag.
Dude, that's a substantial hole.
Yeah. Luckily, it didn't melt any of my clothes. However...
You have meltable clothes?
However, the hair gel didn't make it.
Let me get a close-up of that. Ew. Is it still usable?
Yeah.
It's fine.
Kind of. Yeah. The deodorant was fucked. We had to bail on that.
Oh.
This is how we start our lives as newlyweds.
Freezing.
In the freezing cold.
Freezing.
The first of many tests has begun.
What a honeymoon.
We need to do the arts and crafts.
Okay, I'm doing dishes.
There's shit on the table.
What's going on here?
We are doing some Thanksgiving arts and crafts.
We gotta decorate the bus.
Yeah, to bring together the joy of friendship.
You're doing the turkey?
Yes. The ladies are doing turkeys, and I believe this is called a cornucopia. Otherwise, I'm wrong, but I'm calling them basket trumpets because it's funnier.
Care you're putting into this. Like, the design.
This is carefully thought out. I already thought about it all night while my brain was freezing to death.
How was last night, buddy? Cold. That's it. That's the only word you got.
That's all
cold.
You have to say?
Oh.
I slept on the couch in the lounge after 5 a.m. because I couldn't take it anymore, and Mindy was in the bathroom, and I no longer had another person's body heat to steal. So I went and slept on the couch by the pool table. And then the KOA people, like, looked at me, and I must have felt someone looking at me, and I looked back at them, and I think they felt the pity on me. Because on the door of the building I walked in, said, "Warning, freeze warning tonight. It's gonna be cold, it's balls." Cornucopia Joe made.
God, dude, this is the ugliest one. This is the best one, dude.
You know that cornucopias lay like this, right?
Fuck you.
Why is your fucking pumpkins all crooked?
Dude, they're my pumpkins. They can fucking face any way they want.
See, this is how you're supposed to make cornucopia. Just like that. Perfect. See?
This episode's gonna suck. Doug, what's up?
Fucking roof of the tent blew over on the other side of the fence. Over there. Oh wait, I got it.
What the fuck?
Forever.
I'll get it.
Fuzz.
Here. Want to film?
Is it rolling?
Oh.
Smarter than you ever been.
How's it going?
It's going good. We just had a great sandwich. Go see the hole in the ground.
You see the giant hole in the ground?
Yeah, I'm excited.
How's the temperature?
It's fucking cold.
It's fucking cold?
It's fucking cold.
You look warm.
I'm not. Well, I'm trying to bundle up, but I'm not excited for tonight.
What's going on tonight?
I think it's our turn for the tent tonight. And I think it's the coldest night yet. So.
Doug, where are we going?
I see a big hole.
This guy's got ingenuity right here.
Sit up more on this rock.
This rock here? Is that far enough?
10. 9.
Sit.
Sit.
Stay. Good girl. Good friends.
Joe, what are you doing?
I want a video!
Joe, wait. Last one!
Hang up, come on. Alright, everyone look. Yeah, I think we got it.
Okay, I don't care if you're ugly now.
I'm trying to take a picture for the last hour.
Why are you sitting up?
We're such a happy group of people.
Everybody ready? I'm finally fucking ready. And you are dragging off.
7, 6, 5, 4, 3.
We just got back from the Grand Canyon, which was awesome. Yep. Hopefully we got some good shots, but we won't know until later. Chef Fuzz over there is making tonight's special Thanksgiving dinner, and so we're kicking it old school here. We got the pot sitting next to the fire to keep them warm, and we're gonna get to eat soon, which is nice because it's freezing out.
So we got our turkey in the oven, buns in the oven here. We got the stuffing cooking over the flames here, cooking up little veggies. Mashed potatoes are just staying warm by the fire. Got some gravy.
Potatoes are up.
Oh my god. Got some cranberries. This is camping 2.0, man.
Yep. A little chilly out.
What is the estimated temperature right now?
I don't know, but it's supposed to go down to 20 tonight again. So.
I can see your breath right now, dude.
Work with
Jesus Christ, that looks awesome. Don't tell Fuzz I said that, though. There we go.
I
guess you can't camp on the strip. Giselle, how'd you do in the tent?
Good.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Didn't freeze like Doug?
Well, it was tumbleweed.
So you're saying Doug's a little bitch?
I had a warm sleeping bag. My sleeping bag was awesome. And I had a blanket in there as well. So.
And come on, don't be afraid. Talk shit. Talk shit.
If it walks like a bitch, talks like a bitch, freezes like a bitch.
Doug, how do you feel you're getting married tomorrow?
Might be a bitch.
You ready?
I can still run away.
Maddie, what the fuck are you listening to?
Poo-poo radio.
Podcast. I'm listening to hippie shit and everyone's making fun of me because the topic is bowel movements.
106.7 SHIT.
I didn't think anyone was prepared. It was either that or...
101 the poos. Buddy,
we just got in Vegas and we're gonna go get
like crazy.
What?
We're leaking oil like crazy.
Oh fuck.
Oh shit. Oh, that's not us.
Anyways, guess I have something to film while you're gone.
Well, yeah. I guess we should go. We're in Vegas. We're gonna get our marriage license. We've been camping for 2 days. Haven't showered in 2 days, so we look like a fucking mess.
We look like bums.
But we're gonna get a marriage license, and now we're leaking oil, so we better hurry up.
So yeah, let's get that done.
Did you see where it was leaking from?
Yeah, with the part that was just fixed.
Oh fuck, really?
It might be transmission fluid. I'm not sure. It's not gonna make it.
What?
It just doesn't feel right now.
What happened? What made you like get out and look at shit?
I was smoking.
Well. What doesn't feel right about it?
No, it felt fine until we got to the fucking courthouse. And now Mindy's gonna fucking lose her goddamn mind.
Yeah, I think Mindy will understand.
Yeah, okay.
She's been very sympathetic towards your bus breaking down, I'm not sure how many times now.
Alright. Don't speak so mean about her.
What?
I said, don't speak so mean about her. She's right here.
I didn't think there's something wrong. She just needs
you
a checkup.
You said so many times.
Turn right on West Wyoming
it's
Avenue.
It's okay, girl. We'll get through this. This is so goddamn far away.
Oh,
go the wrong way on a one-way street?
Always.
You can definitely see it.
Yeah.
Oh, Jesus.
Said something happened to it. It won't be done maybe Monday, Tuesday. It is Friday. Because of the holiday weekend, everything's closed, so you can't get parked.
That sucks.
Oh, you want to call your dad and see if he'll come pick us up?
Dad said he can get us in like 40 minutes.
Are we allowed to ask how messed up it is? What's wrong?
It's the same thing.
Same thing?
Yeah. I just have to redo the same thing that they did?
Basically, it's what they said. Yeah.
Why do I have that yet?
So I won't be able to do anything until at least Monday on it.
Yeah.
When I can talk to them.
I guess I don't really have any other options, right? That seems to be...
pretty much unfortunate, I gotta say.
Yeah.
You're correct.
Alright.
Wanna get you fixed up?
Yeah. We appreciate it.
Yeah, thank you.
It's got a bite.
Yeah, it definitely does.
But it may be because it's had the same failure twice that there's something else causing it.
Right. Well, we got a bunch of shit on there, so we'll have to figure
that out. It sounds like my dad's gonna come pick us up.
His dad's actually in town who has a rental car. Oh. So we'll at least be able to throw the shit in there and then
take it back to the hotel.
Yeah.
I wonder if that's why somebody got rid of it in the first place.
Probably.
We've had such high moments and such low moments on this trip. I don't know if I can handle another road trip.
Yeah. Bloodies, I'm sorry, but you failed us. Let's go have a wedding now.
This is getting to be a pre-wedding ritual.
Yeah.
The day before the wedding, empty all your shit out of the bus. Nice.
Ours is not pink.
No, it's not.
Yeah, I know. It took forever. There was such a long line.
A lot of people get married.
Who gets married in Vegas? I mean,
yeah.
I didn't know that many people got married in Vegas.
We're planning on not coming back to the bus if you didn't get the memo.
Yeah, I see that. Are we all like just getting separate Ubers to the hotel?
My dad's coming and we're going to fit whatever we can fit in there.
Your dad is?
Yeah.
I forgot he's here.
Yeah, he's working. He's stationed here this month.
There he is.
Hey, he's my dad now.
Good, buddy. How you doing?
Hi, Dad.
Hi, honey. Welcome to the family.
Good.
Oh, look at that. Look at his belt.
Giselle, you want a hug, too?
Absolutely.
Didn't know he had that.
Yeah.
Doug didn't want to hug me, but...
Now, how are you? Nice to see you.
Good to see you. Come on, Doug.
You gotta
go.
Happy late Thanksgiving.
Yeah, happy Thanksgiving. I was planning on eating something, but I ended up just drinking it.
Oh, I mean, that sounds just as appetizing.
About $100 worth of beer.
That sounds about what I need right now.
Yeah. Doing pretty good.
Got it?
Yeah. Put your hand out.
Hey!
Oh, that's nice.
Yeah, it was.
It was.
This one, all along wood. Maybe you got too much weight to the transmission.
We'll see.
It looks good. Oh, does that AC work?
Nope.
We can fix that, you know.
Sure. bigger issues right now.
All right, well, lock it up.
Wouldn't want somebody riding away with it.
Yes, we would. Locked.
All right. Well, you guys got the Uber here, so we'll get 4 and 5. Sure. Yeah, 2 and a half.
Okay. So this makes car number 3 that we're in for this trip.
We went through
Gladys. Then we went through Dan the man van.
Stan
the man van. I'm sorry. What'd I say?
Dan.
Dan the Stan man.
No, this is
Stan. Stan the van man. The man van.
No.
Fuck that
Stan
name.
Stan the man van.
Yeah, that one.
There you go.
And now we're in...
Patrice.
Did you name this one?
No, I didn't. Patrice sounds too nice.
I know.
We should call it Jesus because it's the savior.
I know.
Finally made it to our room in Vegas.
Where the magic's gonna happen. What? Hey, we're allowed to say that because we're getting married, so it's alright now.
Another rough day for us in the bus. And more problems.
We have this. Oh my god, this feels so good. We're gonna sleep like kings tonight.
It's gonna feel good to sleep in that and not in the freezing cold and get a fucking shower back there. It's gonna be amazing! It's wedding day in Vegas. Parents arrived last night after we broke down. I'm gonna go have brunch with the peeps, come back, get ready, and we're gonna get married today.
So what are we doing?
So we're going to see Doug and Mindy and check on them. They're getting married today. It's around 12:30, so we're going to see what's up.
What time are they getting married?
They are getting married at 4.
So they got 3.5 hours left.
The countdown begins.
That's it.
Elevators.
We have to go through the labyrinth that is the elevators.
Go. Which way do the elevators go?
They go sideways. They go on angles, so... Which is cool, but the annoying part is you're assigned like a certain elevator number. So, like, we have to take a different elevator to get to our floor than they do. So, it's a lot of walking. Oh my gosh,
if you want. Maddie, what floor are we on?
We're on the 24th floor.
24th floor?
Which is, if you've ever been to the Luxor, it's dizzying to look up and down. And, oh, my butt's tightening up. Oh, Lord. I'm done scaring myself. Can we go now?
That's hilarious.
Do you see this? Hi.
I just put whitening chips in.
That's why I'm stuck here.
No.
We don't need Doug. We could use Mindy.
Do you only need me? Can you sign our marriage license?
Hell yeah.
You and Giselle are going to be a lesbian couple.
Okay.
This is hilarious. Do you see what that says?
Wait. Honey, can you hold that open?
Yes. That's funny. It says there's a lot of Lexing going on.
Oh my god. Well, there is tonight.
Mindy, are you excited?
I am. No, you want to see the sneakers I got real quick?
Yes, I do. Yeah, let me see the sparkle bands.
Ooh.
Yeah, pretty stoked.
You excited?
I
know you only have 3.5 hours left.
I know.
That's it.
I know. Ready?
like, and I wasn't nervous, I wasn't like jittery, I'm just like, let's get this done. I think we're ready.
Keep him updated right. So he's there on time.
Good luck.
Thank you guys.
No, good luck. We're in theater, break a leg.
Break. I might break a leg.
Your tiny though will carry you everywhere.
The view is dizzy.
I know. I might have my lips tight.
Ready?
I'm pretty sure.
How you doing, buddy? You look sharp, man.
We were walking around and I was like, are we stupid? Like, how do we not know this by now? Like, we should know where the North Hampton
is. Damn, you got that Leo look going.
Yeah, you look great, by the way.
I think I'm pretty sure you three are coming. Mindy's parents, us two,
and Joe.
And Joe, okay.
Because I'm special.
Yeah.
We know.
So, yes. Go down below Carrot Top, that's where we're leaving. You're gonna grab them, they don't know where it's at. But just wait at the bottom of the escalator, that's where we'll come.
Okay. It's intense right now. I don't know if I can take it. The married life is already rushed. Yeah, dude, you look sharp. I like the bow tie, even though it's crooked.
I can tell Mindy didn't completely take over.
I got
your
it. I got it at Salvation Army. This jacket is $5.
No way.
This shirt, $99. I don't know what the fuck I did wrong. This is supposed to cost more than this, but it was backwards.
Hey! Happy wedding day! Love you!
Repeat after me together, if you will, please. To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For joy and celebration.
For joy and celebration.
For love and understanding.
For love and understanding.
I pledge you my faith.
I pledge you my faith.
Bring it. You have some rings for me.
Amen.
sir.
Condom.
Yeah. That's right.
The rings you're about to receive from one another, they're symbols of an unbroken circle, without beginning, without end, as you're now being joined together as husband and wife. May your love for one another be wise, pure, and eternal. Douglas, you ready?
Yeah.
All right. Place the ring. Just give Melinda. Place it on her left hand. That's the correct one. And look her in the eyes and repeat after me. With this ring.
With this ring.
I thee wed.
I thee wed.
With a prayer.
With a prayer.
That our love grows stronger.
That our love grows stronger.
Through the passing years.
Through the passing years.
Very good, sir. Melinda, your turn. Place it on Douglas's hand. Look him in the eyes and repeat after me. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a token and pledge.
As a token and pledge.
Of our vows to each other.
Of our vows to each other.
Praying that our love.
Praying that our love.
Shall never fade.
Shall never fade.
Very good. Each of these two candles that we blow both tonight represent your individual differences and your similarities. As a sign of your lives coming together in front of all your family and friends, please take the two candles that are lit out and light the center flame together.
Can.
Sorry. There you go. There you go. You'll notice that center flame burns bright, and so shall your love for one another. All right, you two, you can cuddle up there. Just don't kiss them. When I asked you both if you remembered the very first day that you two met, you did exactly what you're doing now. You lit up and smiled. You did that when you told me the story originally. That's a really good sign. Gives me great pleasure today, and all your family and friends who travel all this way, by the power vested in me in the state of Nevada, to pronounce you husband and wife. Douglas, you may kiss your lovely bride. Ladies and gentlemen, a nice round of applause for Las Vegas' newest married couple. Wait for everybody on the camera. Just walk us right ahead. Arm in arm with your beautiful wife, sir, and walk her down the aisle.
Go back in the back?
Yeah.
That's what they said?
Camera operator around here somewhere, he might actually take it and do it.
I don't know.
But he looks busy. Jag off. Everybody, camera guy!
Thank you.
you'll see. Make a left at Darth Vader, Chewbacca, and Pikachu. We're about 100 yards past Pikachu, Darth Vader, and Chewbacca.
My parents, this is our first time in Vegas. They're small fish in a big pond right now. They can't find their way to the Eiffel Tower.
Damn.
Okay. So we're going to have a dance party.
Just look for Pikachu.
Look for Pikachu.
That's your
move,
like,
could have had
him. I'm not sure. Just stay in there.
I'm great, how are you doing? Time of your life.
I said, what are you doing? But close enough.
I'm about to go under.
Uh-oh.
Stay warm.
Got the husband right there, that's kind of brave.
Hey. It's a weird relationship.
What is this?
Are you guys jealous?
Yeah.
Well, we've drinking more today, so
Drunken?
I was drinking more today than they did, so.
How you guys doing?
Lovely.
You've been kind of quiet in the back.
Yeah, he didn't even hire me as the minister. I got demoted to just photographer. I feel kind of left out. I'm really sad. I lost my clergy thing.
You lost it?
Yeah.
I put it on your jacket.
I know where it is. I was trying to make it sound dramatic.